Yep.
Right. We have been talking about Microsoft project, and in this short lecture, we're looking at obviously what is Microsoft project, i.e. the software package. Examples of projects that it could be used on. The beginning of a project, what we've been planning out. Just going to fold into planning the project out. What are tasks, subtasks, resources and milestones. Types of graphics that MS project can show how it displays the information. Some further help, i.e. similar to the bibliography. If you decide to buy it, I've got access to a child download of it. And obviously, any questions? So, starting off, what is Microsoft Project? It's a project management software that's been developed by Microsoft to assist project managing, developing a plan, assigning all your resources to tasks, tracking the progress of the project, managing your budget, and analysing all your workloads. Something I never knew that it's actually included as part of the Microsoft Office family, although it has never been included within any of the Microsoft Office suite packages. And even on, I'm using Microsoft Office 2013 on my computer, and still not been added onto that. And so just where I've got the information from, it's part of the Wikipedia article on the Microsoft project. So looking at some examples of projects we have. The construction of buildings. Next door being an example, the construction of a new college. Planning events, conferences. The allocation of staff resources. So, going back to the beginning of a project. Obviously, the first part of any project requires a forecasting, which means that you have to look at your previous projects that you've undertaken. I'll give you background information in order to help you start planning your project. You look at your current resources that you have, how much budget do you have, what manpower do you have, what materials do you have, and obviously consider the change factors involved in it. The cost of materials could have went up since your last project, and obviously your manpower could have increased, it could have decreased. Just up the next sheet. So once the forecast is complete, obviously you can use then go into Microsoft Project to control everything. With regards to timings, manpower, the costings, the materials. So planning the project before and putting the data onto the project. Using an example from the ICT class of the proforma, which had details of all your tasks, subtasks, milestones, what resources you used. So looking at the next slide, was looking at each section in between, what the subtasks are before that. I need to just enlarge the graphing up a wee bit. It's not come out too well. Hopefully you can understand what the performer would show. So what are tasks, subtasks, milestones and resources? Tasks, so it's a concrete step that is required to meet a project goal. It will represent everything you do within your project. Subtasks, similar to anything that has sub within the title. It's a task or task that is required to perform in order to complete your main task. Your resources are your staff, any items that you're using to carry out the task, any equipment, it also shows your costings. And for milestones, once my graphic stops moving, that's the end of a task. And it's also used to celebrate the completion of that task. So, looking at the actual software and how it displays the info. Actually shows various views up on the screen. It shows all your text input. It's showing all your data on a chart known as a Gantt chart, but it shows it with the 11 diagrams. And the next screen will actually show an example of this. So, as you can see on it, you have your text data on the left hand side. On the right hand side, you've got it shown as a Gantt chart. It used to show the complete breakdown of your project, and the text input is from everything you put in from the planning part when they used on paper. So some further help is there's a 16-minute video available on YouTube, which basically it covers the entire program in a period of 16 minutes. I would have showed it on the mini screen here, but unfortunately due to system problems it's not shown correctly. So there is a small link just to the right of that with the YouTube address. So it's basically, if you're using this presentation yourself, just click on it, it directly goes into YouTube with the relevant files.
Hi, welcome. This is
David.
In this very short video, I want to show you how to use the basics of Microsoft Project 2010.
So it's also got the audio.
So let's make a start.
Child download. One thing Microsoft's got, because it's so expensive for the Office suite, is you can download parts of it to try it out. That's how I decided to get Office 2013. I downloaded a child copy and bought it. So Microsoft Project's got exactly the same facility on it. It's a 30-day download with complete features on it. And if you go in via, that is the official web address for it, but you can go in via Microsoft.com directly. Just type in MS Project Download and it'll take you right into it. Just some wee notes about how source of information is. Quite a good Bible on Microsoft Project that is available. It was from one of the early editions of Project, but there's not been very many changes through the updated packages. Again, with some links, the link to the child download, which I mentioned in the previous slide, and also my YouTube video. So, over to the body of the hall now. Does anyone have any questions?
Would you ever use Microsoft Project in the future?
I probably would do. In what scenario? Are you talking about work, personal life?
Personal life, for instance.
I probably would use it, and I personally more so whenever I go on holidays. I go to London a lot. I always plan things to a minute, so I know where I'm going, what trains to get, so forth. Because I've got medical problems with my memory, and that's why I need to write everything down, know where I'm going, and that. So now I've got access to software, probably utilise it with that. Work scenario, I probably would use in a work scenario. It's obviously after HND I'm hoping to go into university, but if I don't get into university and go back to the work environment, if it's a job that I could use project management in, I would use it. Okay. That is me.